this is a type of teeny tiny dark frog that we only recently started seeing, like just 2-3 days ago. Now we're seeing them all the time. This is how it happens around here sometimes. Like, there are these really giant frogs that I used to only ever see squished on the street, like the size of your hand. And then they started showing up here. And now we see them all the time. Now there's just a new kind of frog out there. And the same with this one. So tiny. Oh, there's another one back there. There's two of them. I don't know if you can see that. Wow. They're all over. It's like they all just hatched or something. I don't know. Also, we've been having loads of mosquitoes, so maybe that's what's causing this bloom of frogs. Wow, so cool. Oh, what are they gonna eat? So exciting. Right now it's like sunset, like 6 o'clock. Past each other. Two ships in the night. We're gonna switch to a new star. Anyone knows what kind of frog this is in East Hawaii, Puna District? Let me know in the comments. It's hard to tell exactly. You can't really tell how tiny this is. These blades of grass are really short. I'd say it's about the size, this type of frog is about the size of a thumbnail, like your actual thumbnail. Or maybe my thumbnail, maybe not yours. Blends in really well into this dirt, as you can see. Where are we going? But yeah, more frogs are great. I mean, someone's eating the insects. All frogs are predators. I don't know if you know that. They're also just kind of, they don't look like anything else, right? There's nothing else that has kind of like four legs where the back two are like a little spring. They're amphibious, which means that they need to, they can survive in both water and air, and they need both. They have different life stages. One that starts out in the water, and one that starts out in the air, the one, and then ends up on, you know, not completely in the water. They do need water on their skin to stay alive if they dry out. I mean, I think there's like weird, okay, I think we lost our stars. One thing I want to show you is something I never appreciated before living out here is the extent to which frogs look like everything, like other stuff on the ground. Like, look at this. Doesn't that look like it could be a frog? Like a sitting frog. But it's not, it's just a leaf. Boop, 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 boop. It just dries like that. Another thing that it could... Mostly they look like leaves. But they can also look like... pebble. Especially, imagine in the dark, that could totally look like a frog. Another kind of leaf that a frog might sort of camouflage as. Not the bumpy kind of frog, but some other kinds. These are lava rocks. We're on lava rock right here. That one could definitely be a frog. But it's not. It's a lava rock. Lava rock. Shiny. Striated. This part really looks like a flow. This is the side part. It has the holes. And this is the bottom. It looks like there was a bubble in here. It's really smooth right in there and reflective. As you can see. So cool. Reflective. Oh yeah, you can see the reflection. I'm gonna look really fast, see if there's something else that looks like a frog. Something else really good more. I mean, this is really, these tiny black frogs really, really fit in with the lava rock. I can show you. Like, this is all rocks that we've put to fill this puka right here. Puka means hole in Hawaiian. I think that's mostly it. Mostly rocks and leaves that they look like. That could be a frog. You know. You all get the idea. Alright, now I've had a chance to show you some things in the little... these are some of the grasses. So this is how big the leaves are that those frogs were hopping from. And this is how little they are. This is really little teeny grass. So maybe that'll give you a sense for how small those frogs were. They're really cool. Alrighty. That about brings our situation to completion here. Thank you all so much.